Hello, grade 12, Mr. G here, and we're going to be making a video on different type of alcohol. In previous videos, we already see how to name alcohols, but now we're going to classify alcohol. We didn't speak about this one before, okay? So, there are three different type of alcohol: primary alcohol, secondary alcohol, and tertiary alcohol, okay? So, let's begin with the primary alcohol. The primary alcohol is the alcohol where the OH, remember, OH is the functional group, is attached to a carbon, which is attached to only one carbon. So, for example, the functional group, which is OH, must be attached to a carbon that is attached of only one carbon. So that is important. The carbon that is attached to the functional group is attached to only one carbon. So this carbon, which is attached to the functional group, is attached to only one carbon. Alright? So this is when alcohol is to be primary alcohol. Let's go to the secondary alcohol. When an alcohol is to be secondary alcohol? An alcohol is secondary alcohol, is secondary when the OH is bonded to a carbon which is bonded to two other carbons. Okay? So, for example, we have in the OH that is bonded to that carbon, and that carbon must be bonded to two other carbons. Alright? Then this one will be an example of a secondary alcohol. But let's not do the whole compound. It's not important. We just need to know that the carbon that is bonded to the OH is bonded to two other carbon. This one here is bonded to one carbon and another carbon. That is a secondary alcohol. So let's see when an alcohol is to be tertiary. Right, an alcohol is to be tertiary when the OH, remember the OH is the functional group, is bonded to a carbon which is bonded to three other carbon. For example, we have the OH which is bonded to a carbon, and this carbon must be bonded to three carbon. You can see there three carbons. Okay, this carbon that is bonded, let's once more not do the complete compound. We're just looking to understand what is the main idea here. Okay, however, let's make the bond for the carbon. Here you can see that the OH is bonded to a carbon which is bonded to 1, 2, and 3 carbon. This is a tertiary alcohol. Okay, so let's see one example of each of the cases of actual alcohol. All right. So let's see this specific example. In this example, you have the following compound. This compound, you can go back and watch the way of naming alcohol, but this compound is called butan-1-ol. This is the name of the compound, okay? So, now, what is important to know? Let's identify if it's primary, secondary, or tertiary. So, let's go here to the OH. The OH is bonded to a carbon, and that carbon is bonded to one carbon here. The other ones are hydrogen, so it is bonded to only one carbon, and therefore this alcohol is to be primary. So it's a primary alcohol. Okay, it is not because it's in the first carbon, however, here is obvious the first carbon, but it's not because it's always at the first carbon. It is because the OH is bonded to a carbon which is bonded to only one carbon. All right, let's see another example. Alright, in this compound, the name of this compound, this alcohol will be pent, is 5 carbon, pentan, 3-ol. You can go back and watch the videos of naming alcohol. Now, let's identify what type of alcohol it is. We're going to the functional group. The functional group is here. The carbon which is bonded to the functional group. To how many carbon is bonded? Well, that one is bonded to one carbon here and one carbon there. The other one is hydrogen. So it is bonded to two carbon, and therefore it is a secondary. Secondary alcohol. So pentan-3-ol is an example of a secondary alcohol. Why? Because the OH is bonded to a carbon, which is bonded to other two carbon. And let's see one last example for this case. All right. So let's see to this example. This example, let's very, very quick go through the naming of the alcohol. It's ending in ol. It is an alcohol. Here's the functional group there. Okay. The second is looking for the continuous carbon chain. This one straight here is the continuous longest carbon chain. 1, 2, 3, and 4 is bute. So it's butane because it's an alcohol. Then you are going to count. So starting from the nearest one is 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this is going to be 2-ol. And then we are going to find out the function of the substituents. Here is 1. This is a methyl. This is a quick recall of the name. Yeah? This is methyl, so it's going to be 2-methyl. So the name will be 2-methyl. 2-methyl butane. 2-ol. So let's find out what type of alcohol is this one. We go to the functional group and the carbon that is bonded to the functional group. To how many carbon it is bonded? Well, it's bonded to one carbon there. It's bonded to one carbon there. And it's bonded to one carbon there. Therefore, this compound is going to be a tertiary alcohol. So this is going to be a tertiary alcohol. I hope it helps. Those are the three different type of alcohol. Very, very quick. Primary alcohol, the OH is bonded to carbon, which is bonded to only one carbon. The secondary alcohol, the OH is bonded to a carbon, which is bonded to two other carbons. And the tertiary alcohol, the OH is bonded to a carbon, which is bonded to three other carbon. Generally, in the question papers, you will have 2, 3, 4 marks regarding this part of the work. So it is important. Thank you very much. I hope it helped, and good luck.